Morning everyone, it's Sunday the 18th, Father's Day. Haynes outdoors again. I've come to River Farm, which is a local carp fishery, and I've just come for the day. It's a 7 till 7 session, £15. There's carp in here to mid 30s. There's already fish showing. I've got one of the shallow end swims. You have to book online. You can't come. There's fish cruising about on the surface already. There's fish showing. You're not allowed to surface fish here, but you know, I can stick a zig on. And I'm just setting up, and I'll just show you my swim. So this is my swim. I'm just it's no braided mainline here, so I've just changed my spools over. Got the new PB products orange line. It's lovely. 0.28, £18. It's a joke. This is my swim. I've just put a load of pellet and that in around these lilies at this far point. There's fish cruising over there, look. The fish like the shallows, that's why I've gone for the shallows. Up the other end, you've seen me fish here before. Up the other end, you've got the willow and that. But there's fish showing, there's fish, I've had a couple of fish lumping out here since I've got here this morning. I'm just setting my bits up. I'm gonna put my GoPro on today, try and catch some footage. Hopefully I'll have one and I'll get it all on camera. It's quite quiet at the moment. I've had a couple of people already pack up because it's a 7 o'clock depart. So that's it, it's my swim, it's where I am. I'll speak to you in a bit. Hello everyone. Right, I've got my right hand rod here, back leaded, just out to that spot there with a little wafter on it where I put the pellet. And I've got my left hand rod, as you can see, going out there with a zig that's sitting probably 2 inches at a guess, just under the surface. You're not allowed to surface fish here, but it's sitting just under the surface, about 2 inches under, and they're working the surface. There was a couple just coming through just a minute ago with their backs out. Try and get a shot of that next time. But they're working the surface. So I thought a zig on that one was the best way to go. So I'll leave the zig on all day on that one. And I'll use obviously my right hand rod for fishing in close. There's some fizzing up out there actually right now. So I might move that right hand rod, but then the lilies are going there. Lilies have started moving, so there could be fish coming in here. This is the dilemma, isn't it, people, eh? Little bit of fizzing over there, but then the lilies are starting to rock. So there's got to be something under the lilies, because it's not that windy. Probably not windy enough to move them like they were moving there. So I'll give that a little while yet, that one. I'll just give that, I might give that an hour. And then I'll start working another spot over there. I'll make up a couple of PVA bags. So I'll speak to you in a bit. Just had a fish lump out there. There's been a few lumping out there. It's probably the fourth one I've seen since I've been here. It's just, hey, I'm still on the surface again there. Another show. Do like it here for a day. I do like doing the odd little session here. You never know what you're going to get here. I'd say there's fish here to, you know, mid to high 30s. They used to have a 40, but it died a couple of years ago. It won't be long until there's more in here. He thinned out the stock. There used to be hundreds of carp in here. He thinned them out and put them down in his other pond. He's got another pond, which is right down there. It's like a stock pond. And he thinned them out and put them down there. And he's put some real nice mirrors in here now as well. It used to just be commons, but there's some lovely scaly mirrors in here now as well, to like 30, just over £30. There we go, it's fish working the surface again down over in that surface. There we go, he's just got his back out. Still fizzing up over there, that spot. I might have to get it out on that spot where the bubble is. I might have to bring my rod in and do that. Got to be worth a try, innit? I can always reset that one, can't I? Keep bubbling up out there, so I've got to do something about it, really. Take the back, oh, that's good, the back head's dropped. It's always good when the back leg drops. See if I can get this somewhere on it. Reel sounds like it needs another service. Alright, let's just click that on there. Some pellet. Right, where are we? Got a bit of pellet out there. Rubbing around. Right. Just leave it out there. Keep an eye on that. Keep an eye on that spot for sure. Right. Speak to you a bit. Hopefully, with a run. Right, I've just come round to check my spot again. And there was just loads of fizzing. There we go again, look. See the fizzing? It's literally where my spot is. Hope you can see that.
Yeah, happy days. So, with any luck, I'll have a fish soon. It's fizzing away right on my spot.
See him up on the surface. That's one of the ones that keeps swimming around with their back out. He's just cruising to here. There's a few cruising about. They're still showing down here. With any luck, they're still fizzing on my spot. This is the shallow end, and when the lake's fishing hard, which it is apparently, there's only more fizzing there. This is a good sign. When the lake's fishing tricky, the shallow end can normally be the end to do a bite. Got all the pond skaters, so many of them. More bubbling up. Better get back round there in case my rod goes. So I've got a spot just there, just under that tree there, where it's bubbling again. I better get back round. Hopefully we'll have a fish soon. Right, I've just changed my right hand rod back to where I had it before, just in this little gap here in the lilies. Put a little PVA bag on it with a load of powder and literally like salmon crumb and powder and pellet from like
1 mil powder to 1 mil pellet, way up to like 6 mil pellet, all different sizes and that. I've put just a little PVA bag, about that big, not too big, just down in that spot with a new wafter on it, a new whittled down wafter on a Ronnie rig, and I've just had a liner on it already. And I had a little occurrence on the Zig as well. I've back-leaded the Zig rig now, just in case the right hand one rips off and goes left. I don't want them to tangle the lines up. So I've back-leaded my Zig rig, and I have put that one out there. And I've just had a little, bobbin's just moved up a little bit. I've had a single little beep on it. So with any luck, that one will go soon. Be nice to get a fish out of here today. It does do day bites, so when they're feeding, I mean, it's tricky, but as you can see, I've got a beautiful little corner here, little quiet corner. I'm staying well out of the way. I haven't got any of my stuff apart from my rods on there. I'm not walking on the stones. I'm walking on the stones as little as possible. I'm just staying on the wood so I don't make no noise. It's got my little seat there. It's bubbling up there now, just underneath. I threw some pellet out there obviously earlier when I got here this morning, so there's a nice little carpet out there. A few little 10 mil boilies, just a few. And now I've just put my whittled down wafter out. It's like a 12 mil wafter, but I've whittled it round so it looks like a little acorn. With any luck, it's more fizzing up down there now. Look, with any luck, it'll move over soon onto my, where I've got my bait. Hopefully I'll be able to bring it back soon, a bit of action. Right, I've just done a new rig. I'm going to change over from my Ronnie rig that I've got on there in a bit. I'm going to make up another little PVA bag, and I've just done this, look. So I've got a multi-rig on a semi-stiff, but with the end section stripped out so that it's got a little bit of movement in the end as well, with a kicker, and it's a hard hooker bottom bait, Scopex squid Nash, and a 10 mil Nash citrus pop up, which balances the bottom bait hard. It's one of their hard ons, the Scopex squid hard ons, and it just balances it absolutely perfect. I'm going to pop that on in a minute and see how it turns. I love a multi rig, it's becoming a favourite rig of mine. Lovely. I'm going to do another little PVA bag, pop this bad boy in the PVA bag. And that's going to go on. I'm going to give that other one, I'm going to give it a couple of hours. I ain't going to go on just yet, in case I have a bite, obviously. Then I'm going to stick this on, because they do like a little wafter here. And I've got a wafter on at the moment, but it's on a Ronnie. So I'm just going to do this. I've just checked this one, and it literally just sits perfect like that. Just wafts perfectly like that. It doesn't sit up high, just perfect, just like that. So that's going to be the next one I do. I'm just going to get a PVA bag done now and get that inside. So, here we have one little PVA bag. You can see all the little fine crumb that I've got in there, all the different sorts of pellet, and obviously my little balanced hook bait. So that's ready to go out next time. Either I have a fish or I don't have a fish and I want to change it over in a couple of hours. We are perfect, solid little bag, absolutely perfect, lovely. Speak to you in a bit. Keep getting liners on my right hand rod, the short rod here near the lilies. I keep getting the tap 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 on the tip as well, where they're bumping it. See if they're fizzing around there. There was a little bit of fizzing, just about where that leaf is on the surface. There was fizzing coming up there just a minute ago, well, like seconds ago. And obviously my bait's down there somewhere, just off that lily pad. There's definitely be something under there moving about. Fingers crossed, get a nice fish out of here today. Bit of movement under there, bit of swell. They're definitely in the area. Probably sat in under them lilies. Hopefully one will come out. I mean, I'm here till like, I can fish till 7 tonight, 7 till 7. So I've got all day. I wait each year, it's part of my Tourette's. Get each year's and I'll get ticks. But with any luck, bit of breeze picking up now. Let's creep back away. So the bobbin just moved a little bit earlier, just a little, you know, 10 mil, little up with the liner. Rod was tapping, but they were bumping the line and that. Oh, there's another liner there. Any luck that'll go soon. Hopefully I'll be able to bring you back soon with a run. Don't know if you can see, just off the back of the lilies there, there's a carp. It's just sat right up under the lilies with its back out. Some little babies swimming about down here, look. See if we can have a wander around and have a look. See here at the front of the lilies, look. It's just come up, it's just brought back up there, look. See it? Sneak around, see if we can intercept him. Such a shame we can't set up his fish here. Oh, we just spooked him. Did he just spook under? I think he might have just spooked under. At least he's in the area. Better get back round to the rods. Somewhere, see if he pops up. Oh, he's fizzing over there on my other bait at the back, look. There he is. That was him. He's just put his head down. There he is, look. He's just gone down and took a mouthful of the pellet I put out earlier. He'll come back and get his head down on my other bit. Swimming away there in the background, look. Speak to him in a bit. There's one there on the top there. Another one there. All, see, they're all coming down into the shallows. I knew they were. Just need to get them feeding. That's the grassy. That's the grassy. juicy there. That's a mid 30. Yeah, that's the grassy, definitely. Just going down under that bush. That's probably the grassy back over there. I think I'm going to change, I'm going to change my zig. Definitely. Right, just change my zig and reposition my zig. My zig is now, see the foam on the surface out there? Well, my zig's about 2 foot to the left of that and it's literally just under the surface. I've changed it to a bit of red foam, because I know that the grassy likes red. I think they're tuned in, obviously, because they're grassies, they eat vegetation more than other things, like predominantly, they're tuned into red, because obviously I think they eat red berries. So I've changed it to red and hopefully it'll come back. There's one on the surface out there now. So with any luck, we'll have a run in that and we'll have that grassy out. In a bit. Right, I've just changed my right hand rock. I've put that other PBA bag on that I made earlier with the multi rig and the hard hooker and the citrus pop up wafter. And before I put the before I flicked it out, I filled the bag up with the Nash pineapple attractant, PBA friendly attractant. That'll go well with the citrus. And I plopped it back into that little gap just down there again. I'll leave that one now. If that one don't go, that'll stay there till I go home now. People fishing in the swim opposite now. They've got one under the bush over there that's sticking out, the bigger bush. They've got one under there. I don't know where they put their other one. I don't know if you can see that bubbling just out there, just out where that bit of dead bush is, coming out to the left of that, that's where my zig is. Hopefully this will melt in a minute. My bait will be left perfectly in the middle of this little pile of rubbish. Hopefully something will be intrigued enough to go down and have a mouthful and they'll pick up my bait. Hopefully we'll have one before we go. I'm not sure what the time is now. It's got to be 1 o'clock, I think. So a fair few hours to go yet. Got a bit of rain due in, I think, soon. Just make sure everything's under me brolly. Speak to you in a bit. Afternoon, everyone. It's about 2:30. It's just starting to spit with rain now, so hopefully we'll have a little bit of a shower and the fish will get their heads down. I've just had a visit from the Environment Agency bailiffs, first time in about 10 years. I've been asked for my rod licence, so that's good to see. Good to see they're here wandering about. Hopefully, like I say, hopefully with this shower, next few hours we've got a chance of showers. Just starting now, look. It's been up and shut the windows on the car a bit and got my jacket out. There's bailiffs over there, look. Hopefully this bit of rain will turn the fish on to feed. Anyway, speak to you in a bit. Hi everyone, it's 4 o'clock. got 3 hours left. Just had one lump out, literally just off this bush just there. Looked like a nice. There's quite a few moving about again. There's quite a few topping out. There's quite a few lumping out all over the lake. Just need one to either get his head down or grab that zig. See him moving about out there on the surface, being up. Cruise right down here into the shallows, look. Another one over there. Hopefully this little rain shower's turned them on a bit. Hopefully he'll come round and grab my zig. They're cruising about again. Another rain shower coming in. Sky's not looking too dark. Chance for a thunderstorm about 6 o'clock, but don't look that dark at the moment. Still got a chance. Everyone, well, it's now 5:20 and as you can see, it's still raining, still no one's had a fish, they're still lumping out everywhere. I've heard them lumping out right down here to my right in this little bay, but nothing. Just sat under my leaky old brolly. It's time for a new brolly. Literally, that's it. I mean, at least it's a little bit lighter than it was. It was absolutely hammering that down earlier. But anyway, we'll persevere. You never know. Right, it's 6:20. As you can see, I've put my zig away and I've put my pod away. All packed up apart from this one rod. I'll leave this rod till last down on the lilies there. I'll leave this one till 7. Everything else is packed away, that rod's packed away. That's my bits there. Still showing big. A few big ones jumping out. Away. single spot here. No one on the lake's had anything today. Nothing's come out at all. Let's have a little wander down here. Rats have started coming out, running through the trees. This swim sort of opens the lake up a bit. There's been some big old fish lumping out here today. Fizzing up under that tree. The rain stopped. Pack up time. A big show there in the middle. Topping out. Everywhere. That's what they were doing on our spots this morning. Oh, there's a poorly gull down there. Oh, he's dead. Oh, that's unfortunate. Turn, took a turn for the worst. Probably hit something you shouldn't. Another one there. Anyway, it's nearly that time. Last knockings. You never know your luck. I know they're under them lilies, obviously they've been there all day, so just need one. I'll speak to you in a bit when I'm packed up in a bit. Just want one. Had a kingfisher sat just on that bottom branch under there earlier. fish moving through, fizzing up everywhere. All that fizzing up out there, look. The mother swims out there. Hopefully you can pick that up. Should be able to. Loads of fizzing all up out there where they've been showing. Fizzing up out there. I tell you, this lake could go off tonight. Looks like there's only a couple of people on as well. Loads of fizzing up and crazy over there in them swims. Well, that's it, all packed up, just about to wet up, load the car up, no fish, thought I'd have one today, all over the place showing, just not interested, and then the rain came, thought that might do something, not interested, but no one's had anything on the lake, five people that were here, no one's had anything, so, not just me. Anyway, until next time, should be back on the syndicate next weekend, so until next time, Haynes Outdoors, out.